next game on the board here. We have got South Carolina 40, Florida 17. Now, I will go on and preface this by saying that Florida did have a lot of dudes that were taking IVs, and a Ball Python Love said it's at San Diego State. That's right.
There you go. There you go.
They had a lot of dudes out with, like, the flu and whatnot, and that's been going around a bunch of colleges down in Florida, and it's not COVID. It is the flu, yeah. Like, legitimately the flu. Emory Jones played in this game after testing positive for the flu. Now, even still, you would not expect Florida to get completely manhandled by a South Carolina team that could do nothing against anybody basically all season. This is a team that beat Vanderbilt 21-20 on a last-second touchdown.
They needed a miracle to beat Vanderbilt.
Yes, and yet they were up 30-10 at the half against Florida. Florida didn't look like they wanted to be there. Like, this was yards per play. South Carolina averaged 7 yards per play with a first-time FBS starting quarterback in Jason Brown. Now, he came over from St. Francis as a transfer. He had played in the FCS and whatnot, but it's not like this dude was bonkers lights out at St. Francis. I looked up his numbers. He was good. He wasn't. This is not an SEC quarterback. He was a third stringer for a reason. And yet, because of the injury to Zeb Nolan and the injury to Luke Doty, he got called into action. He was 14 out of 24 for 175 yards and 2 touchdowns. Kevin Harris ran all over Florida's defense. 16 carries, 128 yards. Zaquandre White, had 13 carries for 111 yards. Marshawn Lloyd, 7 for 46. Like, South Carolina did anything they wanted to in this game. And it led me to, like, this is the only note that I've got written down here. Dan Mullen admitted that his team threw in the towel after the SEC championship game last year. Like, he said, this is not the 20 Florida team that lost to Oklahoma. Like, he told everybody they quit. And now, when you put that out there...
Hang on. In,
go ahead.
No, finish your statement.
When you put that out there and you give off the vibes that it is acceptable to not give a crap after your goals cannot be met anymore, which, after they lost to Georgia, the SEC East was a wash. When they lost to Kentucky, it was a wash. But when you lose to Georgia, it's done, right? Now, again, they do have a ton of guys that had, you know, illnesses and whatever else. I get it. But I'm curious. This is a strange question. Is Dan Mullen trying to get fired?
This is the dumbest shit that we talk about. This is the stuff that I hate, Gary.
All right, go ahead. Give me your thoughts.
So saying that we are not, like, when he lost to Alabama in the SEC title game last year, his season was over with. They were playing an exhibition game we call them bowl games, that don't matter, where all of his upperclassmen aren't going to play anyway. So yes, that's just a practice game. It's just a scrimmage game. It's an exhibition. To say that we weren't, like, super game planning and we're basically using that for an excuse to get the extra practices going into the next season, in saying that has nothing to do with we're still playing in the damn season.
Okay. Then give me your thoughts on what happened.
Yesterday. They're just bad. They're just a bad football team, Gary. Is that not okay? Like, is it not possible for them to just be bad?
No, it's definitely possible, but...
So you think it's more likely that a highly competitive individual in the highest competitive field in the world in college football is willing to just take his resume, destroy his character going forward with any other team trying to get any other job because he just wants to get paid so he can leave? You think he's willing to do that?
That's what I don't know. And that's why I'm asking
the
question.
You do know that.
I will tell you this.
If you don't know that, then that's shame on you.
No, if here's you don't the thing. Know that. I thought that I knew a lot of things. I don't always know everything, so I'm willing to question everything, right? This does not look like a Dan Mullen football team that we have become accustomed to over the years. His teams at Mississippi State never looked like this. Like, they got whipped by some really good football teams. They didn't get whipped by a South Carolina team that was like this, right? It just, I don't know even what to make of what has happened at Florida this season. Like, yes, there were games that they were in that they lost due to mistakes, etc. And there were mistakes made in this ball game, but it wasn't the mistakes that got them beat. It was they just got manhandled the entire ball game. At what point do we look? It's the same question with TCU, right? The TCU that we saw against Baylor, that's way different than what we saw before that.
If the players have quit on him, that's a completely different question. Are you saying what? That's not what you asked.
Right.
You're so asking, is he trying to get himself fired? You're asked, is he putting together a game plan that he knowingly knows is going to lose? That's the question that you just asked.
You're right.
That's not the question.
I had brought up two different topics.
Because losing the locker room is totally different. Having your players quit on you is something sometimes you can't control, okay?
True.
If you've made mistakes in the media or you've made mistakes in coaching that have rubbed players the wrong way to a point where they don't want to play for you, that's a completely different situation. And some of the greatest coaches in the world have done that in the past, by the way.
True.
So that's not an unhireable offense ever again. All right. It's a fireable offense, but it doesn't mean you're blacklisted from ever getting another job. If you openly are throwing games, tanking games so you can get fired and get your buyout, that is a completely different thing. And that's what you asked.
We just lost your video.
I have no idea why. I haven't touched anything. Everything in my house is exactly the same.
Well, we got a nice big picture of you and Chewbacca, so I'm like, we still got your audio, so it's all good.
There we go. I have no idea how that happened, but I literally, my hands were right here being screaming in the thing.
Yeah.
And somehow something got clicked.
Either way.
But that's why I find that question to be ridiculous, Gary.
That's totally fair.
Do you think he's lost the locker room? That's a legitimate question. That's a fair question.
So let's go to that
one. The answer to that.
Let's go to that one.
I don't think
that he is trying to get fired.
That's what you asked, though, right?
Right. That's what I asked.
Okay.
Right.
Just making sure that I didn't make that up.
No, you didn't. You didn't, because I did talk about the team quitting and him possibly trying to get fired at the same time, and I shouldn't have asked it together. The question here is, yes, did the team quit on him? And it kind of looks like that right now. Now, we don't know the extent of all the guys getting IVs. They had to take two separate planes, one with the kids that were sick and one with the kids that weren't, and whatever, right?
We're not talking enough about South Carolina. South Carolina don't want to hear shit about the players you don't have, because they literally have spent 80% of the year playing a GA at quarterback, okay?
Yes.
Because they don't have anybody that can take snaps at the quarterback, and now that guy can't even take snaps, and they're playing somebody who was behind him. So they don't give one hot damn about your inability to bring a fully staffed football team. I'm so sorry that you came into Columbus and got your ass whooped by a bunch of also-rans who nobody else wanted. I'm really sorry that all your stars couldn't make it.
Double O'Neill said, so Florida, is it that good? Do I get to move Georgia's win over a crappy team? Does that get downgraded now? It was downgraded to begin with. When Georgia beat them, they already had four losses. This team may not make a bowl game. Do I think that they're not going to make it? I think they will. But then again, I don't know. I mean, Double O'Neill said, oh my God, my spell checker went insane. Not what I typed. Florida is not a good team. They don't look invested at all in this season. They don't care. Anthony Richardson, by the way, did not play in this game. He is still out due to concussion protocol because he got whooped against Georgia, period. But this was embarrassing. I mean, South Carolina, only one penalty for 5 yards. They had 459 total yards. They had 175 passing yards, and they were able to run for 284 yards on Florida.
I didn't see this coming. I'm not going to pretend that I predicted this at all. I did think before the season started, South Carolina was going to be bad. They were going to struggle to get wins. I thought they would get one marquee win because it's something that that program has kind of historically done. Even when they've underperformed and had bad years, they always find a way to beat somebody they're not supposed to. And I'm not saying a pretty good Missouri team, they beat them. No, I'm talking about a big boy, a blue blood, a one who always belongs. They always find a way to get one of those wins. I didn't see it. I didn't predict it. But before the season started, I thought they'd get one, and they're about out of chances. So,
do you remember who it was last year that they beat?
It wasn't last year. 2 years ago, it was Georgia, right?
That was 2017. 2018.
That was 18, 3 years ago.
19, I don't remember them having one in 2019. Maybe in 2020, early in the season, before Muschamp got fired and everything kind of, you know,
fell apart.
Tailspin from there, they beat Auburn, who was a top 15 team in the country at that point.
That's right. It's one of the games that probably cost Gus his job.
Yeah. Yeah, because Auburn could show up in big spots, but lose to
South Carolina. Because you could have excused a lot of the rest of Auburn's losses, but you can't excuse that one. So that's probably the one that was the coffin in it. That was the nail in it.
More than likely. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.